Hello everyone, today we will learn about life cycle assessment of LED light. What is LED light? LED stands for light emitting diode. LED lighting products produce light up to 90% more efficiently than incandescent light bulbs. How do they work? An electrical current passes through a microchip which illuminates the tiny light sources we call LEDs, and the result is visible light. To prevent performance issue, the heat LEDs produce is absorbed into a heat sink. Benefit of LED light. The first one is the temperature. LEDs put off 20 to 50% less heat than incandescent, fluorescent and halogen bulbs. Next is the size. LEDs come in a variety of shapes and size, but are universally smaller than 1 square inch. It has a long lifetime. LEDs can last 8 times longer than compact fluorescent and 50 times than incandescent. It has low maintenance. Due to their long lifetime, LEDs are ideal for outdoor and commercial lighting application. It also is environmental safety. LED light do not contain arsenic, lead, mercury and other harmful gases. UV free. UV emission are said to be harmful to the health after prolonged exposure. And its efficiency. LED light use 30 to 75% less power than traditional light sources. As a conclusion, LED light is the most cost and energy efficient. Let's move to life cycle assessment of LED light. The first stage is raw material extraction, which is LED package contain aluminium, gallium, nitrates and phosphates, indium, copper, antimony, phosphorus and also arsenic, as the housing contain glass, silicon, tin plated steel, porcelain, rubber and fiberglass. Moving to the second stage, which is processing and manufacturing. LED package that contain semiconductor chip, cathode and phosphate plate, and also bulk materials that make housing and all other aspects of LED light. Semiconductor chip is the integral component of LED light. It is manufactured in 3-step process, where semiconductor material is grown onto a substrate in MOVCD reactor. The first step is substrate production, the second step is LED die fabrication, and the last step is package LED assembly. Do you know that LED chip was fabricated in Germany front end and Malaysia back end, and the final production of LED lamp in China? Next, the third stage of LED light LCA is distribution and transportation. Transport of lamp from China to the US by sea, and then a further 1,000 km distribution within the US. The transportation phase of life cycle representing less than 1% of the total embodied energy. One of the leading LED light manufacturers is in Eindhoven and the Netherlands by Philips Lighting or Signify, which are founded in 1891. The fourth stage of LCA is use or consumption. LED light energy consumption approximately 3,900 mg per 20 million lumen hours, while incandescent light approximately 4 times more energy. The energy consumed by the lamp over its lifetime, specifically 12.5 watts times 25,000 hours. The final stage of LCA is end of life. LED light is categorized as hazardous waste in European Union. LED light will end at hazardous or non-hazardous waste incineration, or hazardous or non-hazardous waste landfill, or uncontrolled landfill, or formal recycling, or informal recycling. Probable end of life scenarios for LED products used in household are landfill disposal and incineration with household waste, by Scullin and Dilton 2012. Through all the benefits of LED light, it still gives many negative impacts to our environment and also the living things in the earth. The first impact is light pollution, and the second is hazardous waste. LED light also provoke the retinal damage and worsen the biological impact of humans and wildlife. LED light will cause light pollution. Light pollution is connected with excessive and misdirected street lighting on a global level. It is suspected to disrupt the ecosystem and lead to adverse health impacts. A research has investigated that the sky brightness arising from street lights depending on the color, temperature at the same luminous flux. Next, the undeniable facts is LED light will end as hazardous waste at the end of life stage, where the large aluminium heat sink caused the impacts to be slightly greater for the LED lamp than for the CFL. Hazardous with the excessive contents of copper, iron, aluminium, which is heat sink, antimony as a LED chip, gold as a LED wire, phosphorus, silver and zinc compared to those elements in an incandescent lamp. LED light also provoke retinal damage. An article published in Neuroscience compared in a very controlled manner the effects of different light sources. It was found that white, blue and green LEDs provoke retinal damage while CFL and FL lamps do not. The authors highlight once more the toxicity of blue light, in particular of the blue LEDs. Last but not least, LED light will give impacts on humans and wildlife. There is evidence that increasing blue content of light can worsen the biological impact on humans and wildlife. The eye has non-visual receptors for blue light, which controls the diurnal cycles, that is the sleep and wake rhythm. The impact of LED lamps on the circadian rhythms is 5 times greater than on conventional street lamps. The negative impacts on bugs, bats, birds and sea turtles are emphasized. As a conclusion, the life cycle assessment study showed that LED lamps have most likely the best environmental performance for indoor and outdoor spotlight applications. The approach to solve the problems of glaring and blue light exposure could be a combination of blue and red emitting LEDs combined with a new color converter technology and frost or opalescent lamp covers. It is recommended that in case of large lighting project, new measurements of particular situations should be conducted considering the technological state of the market, the light pollution and a consultation of the affected user, hereby referring to light impression, glaring and color temperature. To clarify the differences, it is recommended to refine life cycle inventory data and to conduct comparative life cycle assessment of the same lamp technologies. This is the reference that been used in this video. Don't forget to subscribe, like and comment our YouTube, follow, favorite and retweet our Twitter, and follow, like, comment our Instagram account. Thank you for watching this video. See you next time.